Have you tried that new Amazon side hustle where you can make like $8,000 a month and you don't even have to work in a factory, deliver any packages, or be on anybody's phone? Yep, I'm talking about creating low content books with Amazon ADP using BookBolt software. Now, let me be upfront with you. I cannot draw to save my life, and I hate writing. I'm not talking about anything that ultimately requires you to, like, you know, put a whole bunch of words in book. When I say low content books, I'm talking about things like a prayer journal, a diary, a composition notebook, a coloring tablet, you know, things that don't really have like a bunch of words on the inside. And let me just tell you, I created my own composition notebook in 4 minutes, and I'm going to actually talk you through how to do this. But first, the reason why you can make so much money from this is simply because Amazon wants people to create these low content books to put on their marketplace, because people are always searching for things like prayer journals or crossword puzzle books or coloring books or handwriting tablets. And because school just started, this is literally the best time for you to create this stuff and for you to start making that passive income. Now, y'all know I'm all about making some extra money with as little work as possible. And this is how you do it. So you want to make sure that you sign up for BookBolt using the link down below in the description box. I have people commenting all the time that go, where is the description box? And it's like, right underneath this video, just click the little arrow at the bottom of this video and go down and sign up so that you can get instant access to the design software. Because let me tell you, I'm not someone that knows how to design, and that's why I love BookBolt, because they have all of these images already like in their like portfolio that you can select from to create the covers for these books. And on top of that, they actually format the book cover and the interior of the book. So you really don't have to do any work. All you're going to do is just decide what kind of design you want to use, slap it on the book, and then upload it to Amazon KDP. So let's hop right in. I'll show you what that process looks like, and I will show you how you can tell how much other people are making from this so that you can do the same thing. Let's hop right in. So we are officially in BookBolt. Now make sure that if you decide to sign up for BookBolt, I recommend that you do the pro account, because you do get other like software creation tools to sell other things like crossword puzzles, or if you wanted to create like Sudoku puzzles, like those things also sell a lot on Amazon. But once you are logged in, you are going to sign into your account, as I've already done here. And once you log in, you're basically going to be taken to the tutorials page. Now, the tutorials page has a lot of information on different types of products that you can ultimately sell, how to do research, how to use keywords to improve your sales. It has so much information, even the KDP spy, which is like great for seeing how much other people make and stuff. So it's a really cool set of tutorials. Now, before we ultimately design our book, let's just do a quick search to kind of see what's out there and to see which books are actually performing the best. So I'm going to click on where it says cloud. And they've got all these different categories over here. So if you wanted to create notebooks or journals, calendars, planners, coloring books, you can pick from that specific category. But for purposes of this video, I'm going to just do notebooks, and I'm going to do the top 100. I'm not going to put any keywords because I just want to see the raw search and what ultimately comes up when I first type this stuff in. And so the notebooks that look to be the most popular are going to be these composition notebooks. Who would have thought? It's so interesting that these little notebooks are like super, you know, popular, because they're priced really cheap. They're $5.98. And if you look at this person's actual sales, they've got 800 sales. And that's only since July 10th. So I just want to do some super quick math, because 800 sales and you're pricing this at $5.98. That person has made over $4,700. That is absolutely crazy. And all they did was create a little cover. So let's say hypothetically, I wanted to do the same thing. I wanted to create a composition notebook. And of course, I'm going to create a really fun, cute little design. I would basically go into this little icon here and I would click on the BookBolt designer. So when I go into my designer, it's going to have me log in again. When you first go into this studio, you're going to have the option that talks about what the project type is. So we're going to do, for purposes of this video, a paperback with cover and interior. That way we can work on them both kind of at the same time. You're going to give your project a name. And then for the trim size, most journals are generally like a 6x9. But for a composition notebook, we're going to use 7.5x9.25 because if we just go back to our Amazon notebook that we're kind of mimicking, this shows you the exact dimensions, the 7.5 times 9.25. So that's what I'm going to put here. And then for the interior, you can decide if you want to do black and white interior or standard cover. I am going to do black and white. And I'm going to have it do no bleed and enter my page count here of 100 pages because I want it to be a little thick. And then I go to the option that says create project. What I'm actually going to do, because I want to hurry up and just like hop into the studio, I'm going to click where it says try the studio. And then I'm going to get this little pop-up. So basically, this right side is going to actually be my cover side. And then this left side is actually going to be the back side of the book. So what's really cool is when it comes to designing your covers, you can pick from all of these different images that are on Pixabay. So if I wanted to do something like I could type in journal, it's going to bring back different images. I could use an image like this. I could use something like this. But what I want to do is just use my personal images. And these are actually some images that I bought off of Etsy. I got like a pack of images for like $2. That's because I am not artistic. I am not very good at designing things. So I wanted to purchase just a royalty free image to kind of make it easier on myself. So I wanted to have a cover that was really fun and bright. So I picked this cover and I just love it because it pops. It's like so pretty. So I'm going to design this for the front of my cover, and then I'm going to add this also to the back of my cover. And it's okay if your lines are like a little staggered because like this is, you know, kind of like marble, but it's already super pretty. Like I'm already getting excited. Now, we already saw like what the top performing books were, like composition notebooks. Instead of me like creating a title and all that stuff, which I would have to do, I have to go in, like create this title. And I'm like, oh, I don't really like how this black heading looks. Like, it's just not fun for me. I want it to look super similar to the other composition notebook, but I don't have time to create all that stuff. So what I did was I went to the notebook. I went to where it says, see this image. And all I did was take a screen print of this little part in the middle that says composition notebook. And that is a part that I am actually going to use for my notebook. Now, I am not biting this person's design by any means. I'm simply taking this common part, which is pretty standard across composition notebooks, and I'm going to use that to go into my actual studio. Where is it? Oh, it's here. So I use that image to go into my studio so that I can add that as a header. And it's right here. I've already saved it. So I'm just going to make it a little bit smaller so it can be a little bit more clear. And I'm going to line it up. And I know it's lined up perfectly when I see that line, that green line in the middle that you just saw. Where's my green line? There it is. So once you've created your cover and how you want it to look, you can go here, and this is the template library, and it ultimately lets you decide how you want your internal pages to look, your interior pages. So I'm just going to do ruled. Now, if you were doing a different journal, like a prayer journal, you could click this option that says journal. It has the lines down here and a little line here for like the date. But I just did ruled and wide ruled. And I basically select all because this is how I want all my interior pages to look with the exception of the cover. I hit next and then I hit submit. And then it's going to generate my interior pages to look like these. So then that's when it starts to really take that whole composition notebook feel. So once we're done with that, of course, we're going to go over here, download the project. We're going to save it. When it is done downloading, then we're going to be able to go and preview our design to see how the PDF version looks. And y'all, it's so freaking pretty. I just love it. And I want to see what my interior looks like. Oh, my interior looks good. It's definitely got that composition notebook feel. So I feel good about that. So now that I feel good about how my interior and my cover looks, now I can pop on over to the Amazon KDP website to go ahead and upload it to Amazon. Now, Amazon KDP has a tutorial down in the description box. So I'm not going to walk through that process because it's really super easy to set up your KDP account. So here's my account. And basically all you're going to do is answer a few questions about the language, English, and your book title. I just kind of looked at this whole title for, you know, this person that's obviously doing really well and what they used. Now, BookBolt does have a tool that helps you discover what the top, like what the most popular words are as far as like SEO is concerned. But just for purposes of this video, I changed some of the words and I added the word rainbow and the word glitter and marble, and also teenager because I wanted it to appeal to that type of audience. Now it's not a series. It's not an edition. I'm the author. I'm jazzymac. I don't have any contributors. And for the description, again, I kind of just looked at what this person has already and I made some tweaks. This is what would be considered the description right there. So I took that and I kind of tweaked it a little bit. And then I created my own little version of the description, kind of still staying in that format. That's a format that a lot of people use. Down here where it says publishing rights, yes, I do own the copyright and hold necessary publishing rights, or you can say this is a public domain work. So for purposes of this video, I'm going to treat it as a public domain. My keywords that I'm going to use that I think people would use to kind of search for this are going to be composition notebooks, journal, back to school. And again, if you want more information on how to choose those keywords, you can go into BookBolt. And there is a tab down here that says keywords. The best way for you to cheat that is to just look in the title and just kind of use what's in the title of the top performing books. So then it's going to have you choose a category. For this, I chose diaries and journals. There is just a huge collection, but fiction, nonfiction, that doesn't really like classify what a composition journal is. So we just, or a composition notebook is. So I'm just going to leave it as a journal. Yes, it's a low content book. No, it's not any form of adult content. And then we'll just go to the next thingamajig. And then if you have an ISBN, you can use it, but I'm going to say publish without an ISBN, my publication date. I'm going to have a black and white interior with a standard paper. And the trim size, again, is going to be the 7.5 by 9.25. I'm going to bleed the PDF. And if you want, you can leave the cover matte, which is, you know, the kind of dull looking thing. But I'm actually going to do glossy because I got a lot of good stuff in there. I want my stuff to pop. So then where it says upload your paperback manuscript, that's going to actually be the interior. So when you download the stuff in the studio, it's going to download it into two different files. You're going to have a cover file and then you're going to have an interior file. And again, this is your interior file. And then this is your cover file. So at that point, You're going to do the manuscript, which is going to be the interior. And then you're going to upload your cover. And I've already done this for you because I wanted to make this tutorial super easy to follow. No, I don't have a barcode. So I'm just going to skip that. And then it's going to have you do the launch previewer to make sure that it actually looks like something that you want to use and something that is appealing. So we're just going to take a quick look for the quality check. And y'all, this looks so good. And they've already actually put a barcode down there for me. This looks so freaking good. I would seriously just like buy this. And then I'm going to hit approve down here because I think everything looks great. So now that all of that looks good, it's going to show me basically what my printing cost is going to be, which is $2.15. So they actually deduct that from the sale of each of your notebooks or journals or whatever you create. But because of the volume, it's not that big of a deal. So it shows me my printing cost. And then I go to the next page where it comes to where I want to sell these, what territories, what marketplace. Of course, we want to do all territories. And then it comes to where it's talking about the pricing, royalty, and distribution. So the pricing is going to be basically something that is comparable to what you saw the top selling journals selling for. So if we go back to those top selling journals, we see that this journal was selling for $5.98. This one's $5.95. So I think the $5.99 mark is a pretty good mark to ultimately start at for how we want to price this. So I would go here and I type in $5.99, or we'll just do $5.98. And then it's going to show my rate is going to be 60%. Amazon does take 40%. Again, you're going to have a really high volume, so it's still going to be a very nice profit. And then the terms and conditions is going to tell you that it's going to take up to 72 hours for Amazon to review it. Until then, it's going to be in a review status. They actually review it a lot quicker than 72 hours. And it says by clicking publish, I confirm that I agree to and am in compliance with KDP terms and conditions. And if you want a printed proof of how your book looks before you actually put it on the market, you can click this option here and then you'll be able to send yourself a copy of that book or journal before it actually, you know, gets sent to anyone. And then you hit the option that says publish your paperback book and you're done. And you would just watch all the money roll in. Oh my goodness, you're going to be so freaking rich. Well, I don't know if you're going to be rich because I don't know if you're going to do this, but this is a great side hustle. It's that easy. Like people, to create that cover, if I wasn't talking you through it, it would have only taken me about 3 minutes. Seriously, you cannot beat that. Look how easy that was. We literally created a journal in just a few minutes. This is something that you can do while the kids are watching cartoons, when you're on your lunch break at work. Like this stuff is super duper easy. You can pick whatever images you want to use. Like you literally can create as many low content books as you want and watch the money roll in. So please let me know when you've signed up for your account, and also let me know when you actually created your first book and how long it took you to do. Until then, I will see you in the next video. Bye.